Bethany from Ramblings from a Girly Girl. And for those of you who follow me on the HCG community, it's HCG Housewife. And I wanted to show a quick vlog of a mini I made of my husband and I did a quick Galveston trip during the summer. You know, just a few days. Galveston is like maybe a 5-hour drive from us, maybe a little more. We're up in Plano now. I always say 5 hours because I grew up in the eastern part of Dallas. Well, it was considered East Dallas then. It might be North Dallas now. Anyway, I don't know. Anyway, so growing up and living in that part of Dallas, it only took 5 hours to go. I don't even know why I'm explaining this to you guys. Anyway, Galveston's a quick trip for us. That was my point. And I found this just awesome antique snapshot photo album, little mini scrapbook. And I found it at an antique store. And I think the lady, it was like in one of those booths, antique junk store, whatever you want to call it. But it was in one of those little booths that they have, and it said 50% off of everything. So I think I paid maybe, it was either $4 what I paid for it, or it was $4 and I paid $2. Whatever. Anyway, it was very inexpensive. It was under $10. I think it was under $5. But anyway, when I saw it, I was like, oh my God, I have to have this, because we go to Galveston a lot. It's a quick trip and we love the beach. So if we can't get to Hawaii, we'll go to Galveston. Whatever. Anyway, so I picked it up, and since we went this summer, I made a mini with it. But I just love this. I love this because it's the old-fashioned kind. And it came with the black papers that I'm sure are not acid-free, but I use them anyway. I don't care. I don't go too crazy about it. It has to be acid-free. Anyway, it was bound with some leather. It might have been fake, you know, that fake leather plasticky stuff. So I took that out because I knew it was going to be chunky. So, but I didn't want it to be too chunky because I don't know how much this old thing can take. So anyway, I took it apart, and I didn't mess with this because I just love how it's all antique-y looking, and it's a little bent, and I just love it. Anyway, so I put, for the first, hope you can see that. You know, I never know. I'm using a webcam, but I never know what you can see. I'm trying to watch on my computer screen, too. Like I said before, I'm used to actually looking into the camera, so this is different for me. And showing my hands, my nails look terrible. Anyway, I got an old, it's not antique or vintage, but it was an old style postcard that I just put as the first entry up to the thing. And I used these from the Fascinator from this thing, a little Fascinator, can you see that? You know, they're kind of an old thing. I think it's from We Are Memory. No, it's from EK Success. Anyway, so I use the and one that says Island, one that says Getaway, and then this one says In the Sand. I think it's supposed to say, oh, Sun and Sand. There's Sun and then there's And Sand. Anyway, I don't think I have them in any specific order. So then I didn't do my journaling yet because that's kind of personal to me, so I wanted to show this so I could do the journaling while it's still fresh in my mind and bind it. So I left the black because I love how it looks vintagey, antiquey, or whatever. And it looks so good with the, I think it's on the Boardwalk collection of Graphic 45. I got a bunch of the same papers from Tuesday Morning in one little thing. So I thought it'd be perfect for a mini album because, you know, you use the same things. Anyway, and I thought the black background just looks so good with that. It's not the beachiest looking thing, but it looks good for this. And all these papers, I just left that so it would look like I just stacked some things on top of it. Okay, and then there's my hubby. He's building he's putting a beach umbrella in the ground. Anyway, and I used, I got these from a scrappy garage sale one time. I don't even know what they're from, but I pop dotted them. But they're real thick. And then on the back, excuse the cuss word there, it's from a song, Hose in the Water, Blank in the Sand, because he had put his beach chair down there. But I just cut those out with my cuddle bug letters, my cuddle bug alphas. And then I'm going to change this. I left that, it wasn't fixed to it just because I didn't like my writing, but again, that's still part of the song. And then on this one, I used just an old bag. Not an old bag, I made it look old. And then some, I don't even know what that's from, stuff I had in my stash. And I made a flower with, I'm sure it was one of the punches, and there's like a little Coke top, soda top, that was from the same collection that I got at the scrapbook garage sale years ago. And so I got some bling under there. Another flower I put together, and I put a topper on it and a button. And I made this little tag, just something I cut out and kind of, I just colored it all over with my Copics. I don't even know why. But in the background, I still got glue strings on it too. I should have been a little more prepared. Oops, I just broke that. Oh, that's the same one. Anyway, I used a background stamp to make the pink paper a little less bright. I already showed that one. Okay, this is just some, I'm sure I got that at Michael's or Joann's, something cheap ribbon. And I used the burlap on it and I Mod Podged it to make it a little stiffer. I love how that came out. And I used the tiny attacher, the Tim Holtz tiny attacher stapler too. And this was a Kay & Company find. I'm sure I got it on clearance at Michael's. I'd try to get everything really cheap so I can have more of it. Anyway, and it's a little tag that comes out. It's ready-made, and I think I inked it around just to make it look a little more distressed. Kay & Company stuff, a lot of their stuff already comes, so you can just slap it on a page and be done. But, you know, we all, how we all are, we like to play with it with our inks and stuff. And then the back is pretty simple because I just wanted this entire picture of some, we hung out there one day. And of course, they'll be journaling about that. But more of the, I just used the tiny attacher to put some metal on the, some X's on the bottom there. And then this one, I used the same background stamp to kind of darken the blue a little bit. And this was just some trim that I, actually, I think it was a baby's headband. It looks like I lost a button there. But that'll be in the binding, so it won't show. It's from a baby's headband. I got a thrift store. I got a bag full of them for like $3. I guess someone tried to start a business and it didn't work out because there was a ton of this, of these packages there. But I just, I painted it pink with just some acrylic paint, and it came out pretty good. You know, I just like to experiment with things. Sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't. And I used some dollar store twine, not twine, I don't know what it is. It's this stuff here, whatever this is. It's from the dollar store. You get to go home, roll of it. And some buttons from Joann. Yeah, those are from Joann. And there's some bling down under, it's hard to see. And one of those Tim Holtz ideology reinforcers, you know, you get them in a, like a whole pack or whatever. I put that there just to add a little more to the tag. And the back, of course, is just a picture of the, that was our view, and that's where we always set up our stuff. Well, a little further down so we'd be away from all that, but. Galveston's kind of a dirty beach. It's in the Gulf of Mexico, so the Gulf is not clear like Florida or Hawaii or something, but still fun, you know, for a weekend trip. And then, I hope I'm doing this in the right order. Some more of the graphic 45 paper. I love that. I just cut it up so it looks like little postcards, and I pop-dotted that. And I wanted the burlap to kind of echo the, mimic the coconut, so I put that in there. And then some more of those fascinators. I like using those. I know they're old school, but I like using them. And I don't know where these little epoxy sticker things came from. Maybe from Joann. Maybe it looks like something from their collections. And another one of those Kay & Company tags. I love those because they're so ready to go on the page. And then I think these little flowers were from Hobby Lobby. They were in with when you get 50% off of jewelry or something. And I added some pearls and some buttons to the edge there. I got all these glue strings. I need to put a heat gun to that to get rid of them. And this little flower here is so cute. It actually was in with those baby headbands that I found at the thrift store. I'm going to use those quite a bit because when I cut up the elastic part to use as trim and then the button and then the little flowers. Some of them are weird looking, but some of them, you know, go good as flowers on your pages or on my pages. And that was just a simple one. I love this. This is from a thing of buttons. And it had I don't know what it's called, but I had to cut off the back of it so it would sit flat. And this little seahorse is from that same thing. And this trim here is pretty. I got it from the thrift store as well. Some of them are really simple, because like I said, I didn't want it to be too chunky, because I didn't know what all that could take. Got lots of blue strings on there. Get rid of those. And these are just ready for some journaling. Another one of those Kane Company bags. Our beach umbrella, it made it through the trip, but the last day it was pretty much torn up. So I took a picture of my husband taking it to the, like it's a ceremony where he took it to bury it in the trash. And I had this little tag left over. I don't know where I'm going to put it, but I love how, I don't know if you can see it, but it's not glossy accent or matte accents. It's that other one that starts with an S, sepia. I don't know how you say it, but anyway, I loved how that kind of gathered. I used the Martha Stewart border punch, and then that kind of gathered in the little holes there, and I love how that looks. So I want to use it somewhere. I just don't know where I'm going to use it yet. I don't really want to put it on the back because I love how this is the back leathery looking thing. I love how that looks. I don't really want to mess that up. But that's the back of it, and I'll show you how it is still pretty chunky, as you can see. I don't know. I'm going to have to use probably some of this cording. Twine, I guess that's what it's called. I don't know what that's called. Anyway, I'm going to have to use some of that to unbind it together, and I don't know how strong that's going to be. But I love how that turned out. I just love the fact that I found this old snapshot. Okay, thanks for watching. Bye-bye.